Hey folks, we're here once again with Guha Bala, who has shown off just a little bit more of Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2. So Guha, you guys just showed off some new characters. Who'd you show off?
We showed off playable Deadpool, and then two playable villains, Venom and Juggernaut. Really, we took art style that's inspired by some of the more modern styles used for the character to be able to give them a little bit grittier, more grounded, somewhat real-world look. And it's actually a new rendering that's inspired by a lot of the Niven-related styles in the Civil War universe, but all new in terms of the rendering specifically for this game and specifically approved by Marvel.
Now, some of the other new stuff we got to check out today was another chunk of Latveria and a brand new level in Washington, D.C.
Right. You know, as you know, Latveria is the source of international terrorism in the Secret War storyline that's a prelude to Civil War. And where that takes us at the end of the Secret War storyline is an attack on the United States that really increases the momentum for superhuman registration. So we take the player to Washington, D.C. on the eve of the Civil War. Heroes are getting together to stage a rally to be able to convince the people of the United States not to go through with registration. But all is not well in D.C., and the Capitol is under attack. Captain America sees this as the opportunity to prove that superheroes are relevant and important to being able to protect the security of the American people.
Now, one of the new things we also saw on the level was a fusion with Juggernaut. So do you want to explain to us how Songbird is going to work with him?
Right, so every character in this game fuses with every other character. In this case, Songbird takes her sound energy and makes it into a spiked ball that envelops Juggernaut. Juggernaut rides inside that spiked ball, kind of runs inside the spiked ball like a tank and destroys everything in his path. Players will be able to control the speed and the direction of the ball and really sort of blow everything apart that stands in its way. And kind of the physics system and the ragdolling and lots of characters on the screen make it feel great.
Now, one of the really cool little touches that you guys have put in that we caught in the demo was Deadpool, who has a very unique way of interacting with not only the characters, but players. So do you want to explain to us why he's probably the most unique character in the game?
Well, Deadpool, as many fans know, is actually aware in the comic world that he's in a comic book. So similarly, in Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2, we make him aware that he's in a video game. And so in the middle of the action in Washington, D.C., he appears and introduces himself and addresses the player directly and engages you in a boss fight. So, you know, in this game, we're going to see dozens of named Marvel characters that you're going to be able to fight in the form of boss fights. And, you know, the way we bring out sort of the personality in Deadpool is one of the way we kind of really add a richness beyond the actual powers and capabilities to his characters. Now, Deadpool is a playable character. In addition to his powers and fusions, will have all new dialogue. So every conversation that you have with Deadpool will have lines written for him that are written in his personality.
You know, we just want to know when we can play this. So when are we going to get this at home and what platforms?
So Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2 is going to be out this fall of 2009. And Vicarious Visions is developing for PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. The game will also be available for the Wii, the PS2, the PSP, as well as Nintendo DS.
All right, thank you very much, Guha. That is one more sneak peek at Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2. Check back on the site really soon, and we're going to bring you lots more.